Thanks to Babbel, a language learning app, for supporting this SciShow List Show. As a SciShow viewer, you can use our link to grow your language skills with Babbel for up to 60% off and a 20-day money-back guarantee. Sneezing is a part of life. Whether it's from allergies or a cold, sneezing is your body's natural reflex to remove stuff that shouldn't be inside your nose. And it's a pretty forceful eviction. When you sneeze, you're exhaling a stream of air at up to 23 meters per second. That puts about 41 kilograms of force on your chest, which is similar to a mid-level intensity bench press. That much force can do drastic things to your body, from making you lose your hearing to increasing your blood pressure. If that kind of thing makes you squeamish, you might need to watch this video through your fingers. These aren't just stories your older sibling would tell you to freak you out during allergy season. Everything in this video has really happened to at least one person and been reported in peer-reviewed academic journals. So get ready to learn about five of the weirdest things that have ever happened to people after a sneeze. One of the most popular legends about sneezing is that you can pop your eye out of its socket, only to be left dangling on your cheek like you're starring in the next zombie apocalypse movie. And we've already made a SciShow video generally debunking the idea that this can happen to you out of nowhere. But it turns out that a sneeze can dislocate your eye. It's called a blowout fracture, which I know sounds like exactly what I just told you doesn't happen. But it just means that enough air has built up behind your eye socket to make the eye stick out a bit, not pop out entirely. In one case, a 32-year-old was seeking medical advice for their swollen eye. It was very much still in the socket, just, you know, kind of puffy. The air pressure from their sneeze was forceful enough to damage their orbital wall, which is made of the bones on the rim of the eye socket. So the top and bottom part of their eye socket was still intact, but the side was pushed a bit out of place. Normally, this kind of injury happens when you've been hit in the eye socket or you've banged your head against something. But this person's eye started swelling after they just sneezed. While it's definitely not comfortable, this is generally the kind of thing that sorts itself out within 2 weeks, and you won't shoot your eye out. Eye pain after a sneeze might not be a massive health concern, but chest pain that crawls up your neck and into your back for 3 hours is a horse of a different color, especially when it affects your ability to breathe. That's what happened to a 57-year-old whose super-powered sneeze ended up tearing their aorta. You know, that really important artery on your heart where your blood flows out to the rest of your body? Physicians suspect that this extreme response to sneezing was helped along by something called the Valsalva maneuver, which you've probably done before. If you plug your nose when you sneeze, you're already familiar with it. When your sneeze is pushing air out while you clog its exits, it can increase your blood pressure even more than sneezing already does on its own. Like I've mentioned earlier, sneezing exerts a lot of pressure, and plugging your nose just adds to it. But you don't really want to mess around with your blood pressure, because tearing your aorta could be fatal. Luckily, not in this case. The person was given blood pressure medication and recovered, leaving them with quite the story to tell at dinner parties. For some people, that kind of event changes their whole approach to sneezing. This next lifelong nose-pinch sneezer swore off the Valsalva maneuver after losing their hearing from a sneeze. When a 32-year-old suppressed their sneeze, they likely created an explosive force on the inside of their ear at the tympanic membrane, leading one of their ear bones to break. The tympanic membrane is also known as your eardrum, and it's the barrier between the outside world and your delicate little ear bones. When sound waves come into your ear, they vibrate the tympanic membrane, which then transmits those vibrations to the malleus, incus, and stapes bones. But if one of those bones gets broken, then you can lose hearing in that ear. Injuries to the malleus bone are mostly caused when you jam something into your ear. And while it's very rare to break or bruise your malleus via a sneeze, it's still been reported multiple times in scientific journals. And a lifetime of Valsalva maneuvers might even weaken the malleus by overpressurizing the inner ear and causing it to inflate, which could make you more susceptible to sneeze-related hearing loss. But in a marvel of modern medicine, doctors can restore your hearing by patching up the broken bone. So after a surgery, you can make a full recovery and hear just like before. Some of these sneeze effects are life-threatening, but fortunately, some turn out to be much less so than they could have been. This is one of those. You see, this patient broke their neck. To be clear, it wasn't the kind of neck break that you see in action movies. Instead, the 35-year-old patient experienced what's called a laryngeal fracture. Your larynx is your throat pipe that air flows through, so you can do things like breathing, swallowing, and talking. That means this person broke some cartilage in their neck, but not any of the bones in their spine. Since many of these sneezing snafus are caused by increased air pressure, it makes sense that the part of your neck where air travels through is the part that's most vulnerable to sneeze damage. And ultimately, that damage was pretty bad. It was brought on by a, quote, violent sneezing fit, unquote. Now, it takes about 5 times more force to fracture your larynx than you generate sneezing, even with your mouth closed. But it's possible that your body position after a violent sneeze could distribute the force in a certain way that breaks your larynx. While it can be life-threatening, this case turned out to be pretty mild. The only medical attention needed was to monitor the situation and make sure nothing escalated. Luckily, the patient appeared totally fine at the 2-month follow-up visit. It's important to note that everyone I've talked about in this video ended up okay. Some of these people had chewed their way into really dangerous and scary complications, so these case studies are nothing to sneeze at. But they all came away from the experience with the same amount of bodily function that they entered with. And this final story is a triumphant tale in which our main character leaves a sneeze better off than they were before. The story begins with a 63-year-old who had inflamed sinuses. When they went to the dentist and then to the doctor to get those sinuses checked out, they learned that one of their dental implants had found its way into their sinuses. Turns out that happens more often than you might think. But the way this person removed their implant was the weird part. Usually, you need to have a surgery to get all up in your sinuses and take the implant out. And this person was ready to go through all of that, having prepped with antibiotics and medicines that break down the mucus in there. But 2 days after they started that course of medicine, they sneezed out the implant. See, the maxillary sinuses sit directly above the back molars, so as the implant migrated upwards, it ended up lodged in that sinus. But the sinuses are also connected to the nose through openings called ostia, so the implant had a nice escape route too. So this story had a happy ending when they got to cancel surgery without any symptoms a week later. For all of the problems that sneezing can cause, sometimes a good stream of pressure is the solution you didn't realize you needed. There are so many weird things that can happen to your body when you sneeze, but most of the time it's just another trip to wash your hands. All of the events I just covered are pretty rare, so there's no need for this video to keep you up at night. Which is good news, since it's not exactly possible to stop yourself from sneezing for the rest of your life. If anything, you might steer clear of the Valsalva maneuver when you do. This SciShow video is supported by Babbel, the #1 language learning app in the world. And it's #1 because people have fun using Babbel. The app includes games, podcasts, and live lessons with real teachers to keep you engaged while learning a new language. You don't even need to commit hours every day to Babbel. Each lesson is just 10 minutes that puts you on the road to practical conversations fast. You can start building those language skills in just 3 weeks. And Babbel has a 20-day money-back guarantee, just in case you change your mind during that time. As a SciShow viewer, you can get up to 60% off when you sign up using the link in the description below. You can choose from different subscriptions, including a lifetime subscription. Babbel also offers live classes, and you can get 2 free classes with your subscription. Thanks for watching.